线上的弟兄姐妹，大家早上好。
Very good morning to all brothers and sisters who are watching online.
宝宝，我们这时候一起站立起来，我们来赞美我们的神。
Let us all rise on our feet and we praise and worship our God.
在诗篇书里面说
，In the book of Psalms it says.
神创造每一个万民就是要来赞美敬拜他。
The Lord created a human being in order to praise and worship him.
就是要来荣耀他的名。
To glorify his name.
好吧，我们一起前来敬拜我们的神。
Let us come forward and we worship our God.
给我们的神最大的掌声。
Give a great round of applause to our God.
欢迎他，哈利路亚。
Welcome him, hallelujah.
是我的救主，我的救赎，荣耀尊贵，能力全柄归于你。
你是配的，
你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜。
是的，主，我们赞美你。
Yes, Lord, we praise you.
Hallelujah.
尊贵能力全柄归于你，你是我的救主，我的救赎，荣耀尊贵能力全柄归于你。
你是配的，
你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜，荣耀尊贵全柄归于你，你是我的救主，
我的救赎，
我的救赎，
荣耀尊贵能力全柄归于你，你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜。主，荣耀尊贵，美丽无比，神的儿子耶稣，我的主，
荣耀尊
贵，能力全柄归于你，你是我的救主，我的救赎。尊贵能力全柄归于你，
你是配的，
你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜，荣耀尊贵能力全柄归于你，你 是我的救主，我的救赎，荣耀尊贵能力全柄归于你。你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜。
你是配的，
你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜。
我们起来宣告，
你是配的，你是配的，你是配的，我的敬拜。
是主，我们要赞美你，高举你的名。
Yes, Lord, we want to praise you and lift
your name. 全心的来赞美你。
To worship you with all our heart. Hallelujah.
Hey, 继续来赞美我们的神。
Let's continue to worship our God.
全心感谢，全心赞美，进入你的园，全心颂赞，献上慰藉，是最纯的果子。
在你里面，
在你里面，你无挂虑，喜乐满溢，常常感谢，不住祷告，盼望在于你，我要全心赞美，跳舞颂扬你。终一日胜过在世上千日，我要全心赞美，赞美还要赞美不停，一人捧灵魂呼声永不息。
好不好，弟兄姐妹，当我们唱到副歌的时候，我们就跟，如果你旁边有人，你就跟他一起来摇一摇，我要全心赞美，好不好？
When we sing to the chorus part, you turn to the person next to you andWe dance together and say that we want to worship with all our hearts.
Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Woo. 全心感谢，全心赞美，进入你的园。全心颂赞，献上慰藉，是最纯的果子。
在你里面，
在你里面，你无挂虑，喜乐满溢。常常感谢，不住祷告，盼望在于你。
旁边人说，
我要全心赞美，跳舞颂扬你名。
在你殿中，
在你殿中，一日胜过在世上千日。我要全心赞美，赞美还要赞美不停，一人捧灵魂呼声永不息。
我们来跟 camera 来。
要全心赞美，跳舞颂扬你名，在你眼中一日胜过在世上千人。我要全心赞美，赞美还要赞美不停，一人捧灵魂呼声永不息。
就是要这样自由的来赞美敬拜你。
We want to worship you in freedom.
主，我们要欢迎你的同在。
Lord, we welcome your presence.
你的同在是我们的一切。
Your presence is everything to us.
主，我们就是要与你相比。
We want to encounter you.
你是我们的救主。
You are our savior.
你是我们的磐石。
You are our rock.
你是我们的依靠。
You are the one that we rely on.
主啊，今天我们要把最好的敬拜来献上给你。
We want to offer up the best worship to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
storm and raging sea. Faithful, you're my God. You're the glory and the lifter of my head. Your light fills my days and leads me in your ways. Forever I surrender all to between my Lord and me. Lord, I live to honor you, and I long to bring my love and offering. Take me higher, draw me deeper. Storms and raging sea. Faithful, you're my God. You're the glory and the lifter of my head. Your light it fills my days and leads me in your way. Precious Savior, who can stand between my Lord and me? Lord, I live to honor you, and I long to bring my love and offering. Take me higher.
的来敬拜我们的神，我们只有来敬拜他。
Spirit leads me on in the 弟兄姐妹，当我们来到神的面前敬拜他的时候，
Brothers and sisters, as we come before the Lord and praise Him,
神透过这个诗歌告诉我们说，
Through this song, God is telling us,
他就是我们的避难所，
He is our refuge,
他就是我们随时的帮助，
He is our help.
在这个时候，我特别想服侍在彷徨无助的弟兄姐妹。
At this moment of time, I want to serve those who are in nervous.
你觉得你没有能力继续走下去？
You feel that you do not have the strength to continue your journey.
有很多的压力，很多的重担在你的身上。
A lot of stress, a lot of burden is on you.
这个时候，神对你说，
At this moment of time, God is telling you,
来到我的面前，
Come before me.
回到我的里面，
Come back to me.
因为我要让你重新得力。
Because I want you to have strength again.
弟兄姐妹，如果是你的话，
Brothers and sisters, if that is you,
好吧，你张开你的双手。
Let us open up our hands.
你抬头仰望神。
Raise up our head and look upon our Lord.
我奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
愿圣灵的大能现在临到你的身上。
May the power of the Holy Spirit come upon you now.
奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
我破除斥责一切的压力跟重担。
I want to break and rebuke all the stress and burden on you.
所有辖制我们的弟兄姐妹。
All the things that's oppressing our brothers and sisters.
所有的消极。
All the negativities.
我奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
现在。
Now.
离开。
Leave.
现在。
Now.
松绑。
Release.
奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
愿你的能力。
May your strength.
愿你的平安。
May your shalom peace.
现在。
Now.
降临在我们弟兄姐妹身上。
For upon all of our brothers and sisters.
主啊，你复活的气息要进入弟兄姐妹身上。
Lord, your breath of your resurrection come upon us.
主啊，有一个的盼望。
Lord, a hope.
有一个的能力。
A power.
主啊，现在你的圣灵就在当中运行。
Lord, your Holy Spirit is working among us now.
谢谢你耶稣。
We thank you, Jesus.
接下来我想服侍在我们当中。
Next, I would like to serve those who are among us.
如果你有皮肤过敏的。
If you have skin diseases.
有 eczema.
Eczema.
甚至是皮肤溃烂。
Or your skin has torn off.
发炎。
Have wounds.
现在这个时候，你可以在你位置上站立起来。
Now you can raise up from your seat.
然后你按手在你的患处。
So you can lay your hands on your skin.
我听见神说，
I heard the Lord say.
他现在来医治这样的弟兄姐妹。
He wants to heal such brothers and sisters.
然后神也提醒我说，
And Lord is reminding me.
凡现在站着的弟兄姐妹，
brothers and sisters,
如果你在你生命里面有一个的不饶恕，
If in your life you have an unforgiving part,
有一个的憎恨。
You have a hatred in you.
弟兄姐妹，我听见神说，
Brothers and sisters, I heard the Lord is telling us.
孩子，
My child,
放下，
Let it go.
放下，
Let it go.
然后呢，我要来医治你。
And I'm here to heal you.
主耶稣，我奉耶稣的名字，
Lord Jesus, in Jesus' name.
你有恩典在这些弟兄姐妹身上。
Your grace is upon all these brothers and sisters.
主耶稣，我相信主，你就是最大的医生。
Lord Jesus, I believe that you are the greatest doctor.
当我们愿意释放、饶恕这些人的时候，
Lord, as we are willing to release and forgive these people.
主啊，愿你的能力进入这些弟兄姐妹身上。
Lord, may your power and strength come upon all these brothers and sisters.
甚至我奉耶稣基督的名字，
In Jesus' name.
愿圣灵的能力，
the power of the Holy Spirit,
超自然的医治，
a supernatural healing,
现在
now,
进入到弟兄姐妹身上。
Come upon our brothers and sisters.
主耶稣，我要宣告，
Lord Jesus, I want to proclaim,
所有这些 eczema,
all this eczema,
皮肤过敏的，
all this sensitivity,
发炎溃烂的，
all these wounds that's on the skin,
奉耶稣基督的名字，
in Jesus' name,
现在
now,
都要完全得医治，
must be healed completely.
我奉耶稣的名字宣告，
in Jesus' name, I proclaim,
因着你超自然的能力，
because of your supernatural power,
所有的皮肤的组织，
all the tissues of the skin,
要再一次的恢复，
will be restored.
所有的溃烂，
all the wounds,
要完全的停止，
will stop now.
并且我要宣告，
and I will proclaim,
一个生命力，
a life,
一个生命，
a breath of life,
新的一层的皮肤，
a new skin,
现在要长出来，
now will grow.
奉耶稣名字，
in Jesus' name,
我们凭信心来宣告，
we proclaim it in faith.
主耶稣帮助我们，
Lord Jesus, may you help us.
让我们也凭信心来领受，
so that we can receive in faith.
谢谢你耶稣，
we thank you, Jesus.
我们相信，
Lord, we believe.
我们同心合意的祷告，
as we pray in unity,
主你都垂听，
Lord, you will listen to our prayer.
而且你的能力医治现在也愿 运行在我们当中。
And your power and your healing will come upon us now.
谢谢你，耶稣。
Thank you, Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的名，我们祷告。
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
我将热烈的掌声归给我们的神。
Let's give a round of applause to our God.
弟兄姐妹，如果你得医治
，Brothers and sisters, if you are healed,
你得释放
，If you are being released,
好不好？你可以透过我们荧幕前的一些的啊留言区。
So through our comments on the screen,
或者你可以通知你的组长
or you can tell your cell leaders,
你要为主来做见证
you want to testify for our Lord.
因为我们相信透过你的见证呢，这个医治可以继续复制
Because we believe through your testimony, this healing power will duplicate.
愿神祝福大家
May God bless all of us. Shalom to all brothers and sisters.
现在是我们领圣餐的时候。
Now is the time for our Holy Communion.
每次领圣餐的时候，我们又再一次的进到神的同在里面，并且来思想我们生命的问题。
Once again, as we receive the Holy Communion, we come back to God and examine on our own lives.
因为在哥林多前书十一章二十七到二十九节这里说
，Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 27 to 29 it says,
所以无论何人不按理吃主的饼喝主的杯，就是干犯主的身主的血了。人应当自己省察，然后吃这饼喝这杯，因为人吃喝若不分辨是主的身体，就是吃喝自己的罪了。
Therefore, whoever eat this bread or drink this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body.
所以原来我们来到圣餐台前的时候，我们是要一个以一个很认真的态度来去面对神。
So as we come before the table of the Holy Communion, we come with a serious attitude.
因为圣餐呢，就是依表着耶稣的宝血还有身体。
Because the Holy Communion is representing the blood and also the body of Christ.
耶稣就是这么认真的为了爱我们，他舍自己的身体还有宝血。
And because Jesus loved us, this is how he has sacrificed for us.
因着他的鞭伤，我们得医治。
And through his stripes, we get healed.
因着他流的宝血，他来赦免我们的罪。
And through his blood, we are forgiven.
好不好？在这时刻，我们花一点时间来进入到神的同在里面。
So at this moment of time, let us spend a moment to come into the Lord's presence.
来思想在这一段期间里面，我们有没有认真的来对待跟神的同在呢
？Let us examine ourselves if we have treated God seriously throughout this period of time.
我们有渴慕神就在我们的生命当中吗？
Did we desire for the Lord's presence in our life?
我们有渴慕来听神的话语吗？
Did we desire to hear the words of the Lord?
我们生命当中是否还有很多的软弱？
Is there still many weaknesses in our lives?
我们在这时候真的是要进到神的同在里面。
So at this moment of time, we truly want to come into the presence of the Lord.
靠着神的恩典
And through His grace,
他的鞭伤
Through His stripes,
他的宝血
through his blood,
我们真的可以得到恢复
so that we can be restored.
主耶稣在被卖的那一夜
the Lord Jesus on the same night which he was betrayed,
他拿起饼来
he took bread,
祝谢
And he has given thanks.
擘开
He broke it.
说这是我的身体为你们舍的
And said, take it. This is my body which is broken for you.
你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我
Do this in remembrance of me.
我们一同来吃主耶稣的身体
Let us take the body of Christ together.
饭后
So after the supper,
就照样拿起杯来
In the same manner, he also took the cup,
祝谢递给他的门徒说
saying, "This cup,
你们每逢喝的时候要如此行
This cup is a new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it,
为的是纪念我
in remembrance of me.
我们一同喝
Let us take it together.
我们一起祷告
Let us come and pray.
主耶稣，我们感谢你。
Lord Jesus, we thank you.
因为你在十字架上的恩典。
Because of your grace on the cross.
我们今天可以得到恢复。
Today we can be restored.
我们身上的疾病。
All of our sickness.
可以得医治。
Can be healed.
我们所犯的罪。
All the sins that we have committed.
只要我们来到你的宝座前认罪。
As long as we confess our sins before your throne.
你的宝血就会来洁净我们。
Your blood will come and cleanse us.
主啊，透过今天的圣餐
，Lord, through the Holy Communion today,
我们要再一次连接与你。
Once again, we want to reconnect back with you.
再一次认真的看待我们自己的生命。
And we want to seriously examine ourselves.
愿你天天向我们说话。
May you speak to us daily.
至等到主再来。
Until you come once again.
奉耶稣的圣名祷告。
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹，是我们来到神面前献上我们礼物的时候。
Brothers and sisters, now is the time for us to come before the Lord and also give our presents to the Lord.
在马拉基书的第三章第十节有说到。
So in the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 10, here it says.
万军之耶和华说，你们要将当纳的十分之一全然送入仓库，使我家有粮，以此试试我，是否为你们敞开天上的窗户，倾覆于你们，甚至无处可容。
Bring all the tithes into the storehouse that there may be food in my house and try me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the window of heavens and pour out for you such blessings that there will not be room enough to receive it.
当我们将我们的奉献，我们的十分一献在神面前的，神有祝福临到我们。
When we bring forth our offerings and our tithes before the Lord, Lord will give us blessings.
而且这个祝福是满盈到无处可容的。
And this blessing is so abundant.That there will be not enough room for us to receive it.
不但如此，在第十一节。
And not only so, in verse 11 here it says,
万军之耶和华说，我必为你们斥责蝗虫，不容它毁坏你们的土产，你们田间的葡萄树在未熟之间也不掉果子。
And I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, that so that he will not destroy the fruit of your ground, nor shall the vine fail to bear fruits for you in the field, says the Lord of hosts.
原来神也会保守我们手中所做的一切工作。
And the Lord will also keep whatever work that is in our hand.
并且我们所做的必然带来果效，必然有。成果
and whatever that we do will bring an outcome, will bear fruits.
蝗虫神会斥责
and the Lord will rebuke the devourer.
未熟的果子神会保守，不让它掉落
and the fruits that is yet to ripe, God will keep it for us.
好让我们的收成都是盈满的，都是成熟的果子
so that we will have abundance in our harvest.
我感觉神在这个时间点要对我们弟兄姐妹说
I felt that the Lord is want to tell all of our brothers and sisters at this moment of time.
我要为你们赶出蝗虫
I want to rebuild the devourer for you.
我要看顾你葡萄树上的果子
I want to keep the fruits in your wine.
我要看顾你手头上的工作
I want to keep the work of your hand.
不容它毁坏
so that it will not be destroyed.
未熟之间必然不会掉在地上
it will not fall before it's ripen.
弟兄姐妹，让我们来领受神的祝福
Brothers and sisters, let's come and receive the blessing of our Lord.
父神，我们来到你面前。
Heavenly Father, we come before you.
主，我们满心感恩的带上我们的礼物献在你面前。
With great thanksgiving, we bring forth our present before you, Lord.
父神啊。
Heavenly Father,
万军之耶和华
the Lord of hosts,
你曾如此说
you always says,
当我们将当那十分之一送到你仓库的时候
when we bring forth the tithes into your storehouse,
你的祝福从天上降下到我们，给我们。
Your blessings will come from heaven to us.
并且主啊，你会为我们斥责蝗虫。
And Lord, you will rebuke the devourer for us.
保护看管我们的果子。
And keep our fruits.
直到它成熟为止。
Until it's ripen.
主啊，这应许你曾经说过。
Lord, you have mentioned this promise.
也临到如今仍然在运行当中
and now it is still ongoing
主啊我们要得着这应许
Lord we want to grab hold of this promise
主啊你看顾我们弟兄姐妹
Lord you keep every of our brothers and sisters
主啊你这从天上来的祝福还有从天上来的保护
Lord you keep your protection and your blessings from heaven
都要临到我们的弟兄姐妹
may come before our brothers and sisters
让他们在这段期间当中
so that throughout this period
人能够在财务上资产上能够大大尊荣神的 名字。
So they can honor your name greatly in their finances.
见证神，你就是保守看顾我们的神。
And witness that God, you are the God that keep us and protect us.
主，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
祝福我们弟兄姐妹。
Bless every of our brothers and sisters.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Shalom to all.
我们 GA 一次欢迎，永远欢迎。
GA once welcome, forever welcome.
如果你是第一次参加我们网上线上崇拜的话
，If this is your first time joining our online worship,
我们欢迎你扫描以下的 QR code.
We'd like to invite you to scan the QR code on the screen,
让我们可以更多的认识你
，so that we can know you more.
然后今天有两项的家事报告
，so today we have two announcements.
第一呢。
The first one,
如果大家想要参与奉献支持我们这一班的学房学生
if you want to participate and to offer up for our Gati students,
就是支持学房教育奖学金
that is to participate and support the Gati fund,
让你 的奉献可以栽培更多的年轻的一班起来服侍神
so that your offering can build up the next generation to rise up to serve God.
当你将奉献献上的时候呢
？As you offer up,
请你注明 GAEDU.
As you offer up, please do remark it as GAEDU.
这样我们就知道你要支持这一个的学房奖学金。
So that we will know that this offering is for the Gati Fund.
然后第二项报告呢
？So the second announcement.
下星期就是华人新年咯。
The upcoming week will be our Chinese New Year.
这样二月十一号到十四号呢？教会就会有新年假期
So our church will be having our Chinese New Year break on the 11th to the 14th of February
如果你有任何的急事的话请你联络你的组长
You may contact your cell leaders if there's any urgent matters
所以在此我要预祝大家新年蒙恩
So here I want to wish you way ahead Happy Chinese New Year
这样年三十晚那一天呢就是2月11号
So on the 11th of February
我们晨祷依然照旧
We will still have our morning devotion
今天的报告到此为止
So this is all for our announcement today
欢迎弟兄姐妹回到我们这一期主任牧师的话我们特别要欢迎 S 牧师在我们当中
你好
我们掌声欢迎他是的我们星期三呢经历了一个非常特别的 call to all 那在当中呢其实我们再一次的把、我们这整个的直播呢搬到来、S 牧师的家那我们当天呢已经做完六点半就开始做、那个的set up 啊，还有很多的预备。那所有东西我们都就绪了。那要开始之前哦，我们才发现
是
那个网络不能操作。
是。
那我们以为是那个网络问题啊，然后我们就去做那些很多的设定啊等等，但做来做去都做不到，一直延迟到八点半，然后很多弟兄姐妹其实在网上在等着我们。
嗯。
然后开始有同工就发讯息说，就为媒体祷告啊，为整个的网络祷告，但是持续如何的做都做不到。当时候我们有敬拜的预备好了，我们有带祷告的预备好了，那我们就怎样办呢？我们就想不能再等下去，那我们就开始想哦，我们可能要转换频道，就从 YouTube 的直播去到 Zoom 嘛。那我们很快的就用 Zoom 的方式，但是没想到 Zoom 其实有一个它的极限啊，就是我们只有100个人可以进去。所以我们就要用两个的 Zoom 的 account 来去做这个的直播。那我们突然间就发现，哎，为什么会这样呢？因为我们已经做好所有的预备啦，我们已经想把最好的我们预备心来一起祷告，但是却因为网络，却因为 Zoom 的限制，所以让我们这个的祷告会其实有很多很多的挑战跟艰难。
是啊。是啊。
那其实也对我们说有一个很大的考验。那我想听听牧师嘛，牧师在这样的混乱里面，而且又要去带祷告会，然后又要面对很多弟兄姐妹，那时候已经有300多个
view
弟兄姐妹在等着，
就是频道进来，
频道进来在等着呢，所以其实是蛮挑战的。
是，
那牧师可以跟我们分享一下你的心情，或者是你的你觉得怎样？
表示说人又要 upgrade 了啊，送100个不能就去到500吧？
对，
所以我觉得这就是我们一直要变通的东西哦。这个时候局限，然后我们要找一个方法，我们又可以怎么样去到哪里？所以我觉得这个就是我们要去思考的。
是，
原来从我们开始录制啦，开始直播节目啦，从我们没有这个没有那个，但是一直慢慢在 upgrade 的过程里面，我们发现很多东西我们又可以做到。
是，
可是来到网络这件事上，大家又被
措手无及，因为
对呀，
这不是我们可以做的。对，
然后我们发现原来可能有一天会是这样的哦。
是。
是怎样呢？就是不能实体，网络可能会中断，
是，
就好像刚刚发生在
一
个缅甸嘛，他们突然间有一个紧急的叫做什么？
紧急状况。是，
其实你们都知道政治的变化咯，
是，
然后突然间他们那一天就那个媒体啊，通讯啊，全部停，
直播全部停。
然后我们的分堂也，我找不到他们，他们也找不到我们。其实我们很为他们紧张的。
是，
所以你可以看到，当来到这样的一个局势的时候，哎，我们弟兄姐妹应该怎么样？我们可能不能见面，可能你连网络都没有的，
也联络不到人，
的时候怎么办？
对，
所以我就发现，可能电话会有吧。可能只有电话最基本的一个电讯，
是，
我们就要透过什么方法可以找到人，或者说我们可以怎么 connect， 就是有一个连续，那可能就是用最基本的方法。我觉得在福音受限制的地方，他们甚至是到他的地方，就是开车到那个人的地方，甚至走路到那个人的地方，就跟他传一个口讯了，就是可以把一个信息告诉他，
是，
甚至他们就在那里一起读圣经，
是，
而且有一些甚至被抓进监牢的，他们就把过去记得的圣经把它抄写，所以等于他们记得了多少，他们就抄写多少，
是，
所以我觉得在这个情况，在星期三发生的事情，其实是给我们有一个突破，给我们有一个新的看见，
是。那我真的想的，也给我们一个弟兄姐妹，我们一个很大的深思。很多时候我们依靠一样东西，我们觉得它是不会有问题，或者我们习以为常，我们都觉得是这样走。
是，
但是来到一个这样的光景的时候，真的我们要回到最基本的。那我们觉得我们个人对神的信仰的关系，我们可以如何的去维持？那在危机的时候，如果不是谁都找不到了，谁也联络不到教会，也没有实体，也没有线上了，你可以怎样的敬拜？你可以如何的继续的来到神的面前？那真的也像牧师说，要回到去小组。
是，
那我们觉得真的小组这个最小的单位，其实是可以帮到每一个人，可以继续向上，继续跟随神。那我觉得这个是真的非常宝贝的。那我们也说说啊，其实聚业的弟兄姐妹也真的非常的棒。
是，
我觉得在这件事情上面。我真正我说嘛，一开始就有300多位的人，300多个 view 在等着我们。其实在监中有很多挑战，但是我告诉你，他们从头到尾都在跟随。
是，
所以我觉得这个真的是 GA 量给神量给 GA 的一个非常棒的礼物。
是，
有一班非常爱神、忠心跟随神，
是，
就算面对挑战。有艰难，很多不方便，但是他们仍然跟随了。那我觉得真的是很棒。
我觉得是因为他们有信任哦，
是，
然后有爱，他知道我们一定会为他们想，他们也会知道有一些时候不是就是会去理解啊，然后他们就不会离开岗位，
对，
不会离开岗位，然后可能他们会心中说为什么会这样，为什么这样，但是呢他们还是守在那里，
哦，
所以我觉得这个是非常宝贝的。我觉得来到这一个这么黑暗的一个时代，这么多挑战，特别我们给这一个疫情搞到大家可能都会面对经济困难啊，问题了，
是，
我们会怎么样跟随神？我刚才在开始就说了， 因为可能真的要靠人和人之间的那个互动的，我们才能够在信仰里面有根基的，
是，
所以真的很靠小组长，真的很靠在牧养接触人，可能你三个五个十个，我们就可以透过组长可以有一个联系，
是，
并且呢可能真的可以上门哦去找你，所以这个是我们在这一次的冲击里面，我真的在这里看到弟兄姐妹小组的生活要如家庭一样紧密的联系，因为有一天真的会来到的，而且那个挑战应该是超乎你的能力所能面对的，所以这个是我很深的一个感触啊。
是的，牧师，我认同你说小组真的很重要。那我们看回星期三的祷告会，其实也是从小组下去发动的。
是。
那当天其实我们说有300多个 view， 其实如果我们看起来有国内外、海外的分堂也一起参与，其实看到这个人数是多过的，我们可以说600-700人在祷告。
是。
所以我们也看到这个祷告是非常非常有能力。跟非常重要，而且我们是为国家啦，为教会啦，为甚至是很多国外的一些的国家的状况来祷告，我觉得这个是真的可以触摸到神。我觉得即便没有网络，即便我们没有通讯，但是我觉得弟兄姐妹的那个同心，那个不放弃，我觉得真的可以把祷告他们的事项带到神的面前。
是的，是小组生活啦，然后小组的祷告生活啦，还有加上家庭的那个关系啦，假使这一些都能够拉紧的话，其实我们在跟随神这条路上呢并不孤单的，所以我在这里呢真的很鼓励凡是在荧幕前的弟兄姐妹，我觉得在这一个黑暗的时期，我们最要做的就是当然是你个人的跟随神，因为一切都面对挑战的时候，你怎么跟随神，
是
你怎么样跟神的那一个关系，和你就算在什么东西都没有的情况下，你仍然可以敬拜，你仍然可以呼求，你仍然可以跟神有一个交心的时刻，还有你也有圣经啊，所以你的读经生活，你的基础一定是要有一个渴慕，还有加上小组的生活，好，家里面的关系，所以我们这样子一起走的话，我们就走得稳健，你就会发现前面的路是有路的，而且是有神同在的，所以我鼓励所有的弟兄姐妹，我们一同来跟随神，跟随教会，跟随你的组长，也跟随你的爸爸妈妈，我们一同拉紧我们的关系，愿神祝福你们哦。
阿们，我们真的要起来回应主任牧师的话。那我觉得今天 S 牧师对我们说的这番话，我们要紧紧记得，而且抓着，而且去行。因为未来的日子挑战是不是我们可以想象的？但是借着个人的跟神的关系、小组家庭的关系，我们就可以面对再大的挑战。
是
的，这一期主任牧师的话呢，我们就到这里。那我们下个星期再见，拜拜，
拜拜。
弟兄姐妹早安
，Good morning, brothers and sisters。
今天非常开心，可以和大家一起来分享神的话。
Very happy to share the word of God with everyone。
今天非常特别
，And today is very special。
因为有两个讲员
，Because we have two speakers。
上半段会由我来分享
，So for the first half, I will be sharing。
下半段就会由 Pastor 和夏娜来分享。
For the second half, it will be shared by Pastor Hosanna.
对我们来说是一个新的尝试。
It is a very new combination for us.
当我们在领受要说什么的时候
，As we were receiving what to share about,
我们领受到大卫。
We received that we need to share about David.
因为大卫他的人生经历很多的高高低低。
Because in his life, he experienced the highs and also the lows.
他的成就是以色列历史当中是无可比拟的。
His accomplishment is something incomparable in the history of Israel.
他在少年的时候就一个人战胜了哥利亚，拯救了整个国家。
When he was young, he overcame Goliath the giant and also saved the Israelites.
他也带领他的团队去建立以色列国。
He led his team to build the nation of Israel.
他也为耶和华预备建殿的材料。
and prepare the materials for the building of the temple for the Lord.
才设立祭司24班次来服侍神。
He set up the 24 divisions of the priests to serve the Lord.
但我们也看见他的软弱。
But we also saw his weaknesses.
使他跌倒啊，使他被追杀，甚至被他的家人背叛。
They caused him to fall and also being betrayed by his family members.
但是他每一次哦，他都可以逆境中呢再得胜。
But every time he can overcome all the adversities.
得胜再得胜。
To have the victory upon victory.
这个不就是我们年头所领受的吗？得得2021。
Isn't it something that we have received at the beginning of this year that is victories 2021?
所以我们要来探讨他的得胜的秘诀是什么。
So let's look at his tips of victory.
那这个要回到他的第一个战役，就是战胜哥利亚。
We need to return to his first battlefield, that is to overcome Goliath.
但是战胜哥利亚之前呢
？But even before that，
更要再回去再看呢，在无人的时候呢，大卫是个怎样的人
？We need to rewind further and see what kind of person David was when no one was around.
或者是大卫是 nobody 的时候，他是个怎样的人
？Or in other words, when David was a nobody, what kind of person he was？
原来大卫得胜的。关键呢，是因为他有个得胜的内室。
The key of victory of David was because he has an inner chamber.
与神独处的内室。
An inner chamber that he has interaction with the Lord.
所以今天我们的主题是得胜的内室。
So our title today is the victorious inner chamber.
我会讲第一部分视为无人时的大卫。
I will talk about the first half that is David in the presence of no one.
那Pastor Hosanna呢会讲第二部分万众瞩目中的大卫。
Pastor Hosanna will be preaching about the second half that is David in the eyes of everyone.
好，我们来看第前半段。
So let us
视为无人时的大卫。
Look at the first half that is David in the presence of no one.
那我第一点就是内室中与神连结。
So my first point is connect with God in the inner chamber.
弟兄姐妹问大家一个问题。
So I want to ask everyone this question.
当没有人的时候，我们会做什么
？When no one is around, what will we be doing？
或者当爸爸妈妈或者是老板啊，权柄不在的时候，我们会做什么
？When our parents or authorities, our boss were not around, what would we be doing？
如果没有警察，我们会做什么
？If there's no police, what are we doing？
我想现在 MCO 的时候，如果没有警察，应该会跨州吧。
And I believe that if there's no police now, then we'll actually cross the borders.
啊，这个时候我们真的真我就会出来了。
The true self will be revealed.
所以当视为没有人的时候呢，就是真正自己的品格会展现出来的时候。
So when there's no one around, then our true characters are being shown.
大卫常常一个人去放羊。
And David often tend the sheep by himself.
那如何知道呢
？How do we know about this？
在撒母耳记16:10-11。
In 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 10 until 11, it says.
他这么说：耶西叫他七个儿子都从撒母耳面前经过。撒母耳说：这都不是耶和华所拣选的。撒母耳对耶西说：你的儿子都在这里吗？他回答说：还有一个小的，现在放羊。撒母耳对耶西说：你打发人去叫他来，他若不来，我们必不坐席。所以从这边看呢，大卫是很常一个人在牧放他爸爸的羊。
So from here we can see that David often tend the sheep by himself.
这个是个没人看得见的差事。
And that is a task that no one can actually see.
那没人看得见的差事，我们做什么都可以咯。
So we can actually do anything we want.
我们可以睡觉，我们可以吃东西，我们可以发呆，我们可以玩手机。
We can actually sleep, eat something, daydream, or play with our handphones.
但是他却在那里弹琴。
But he actually played the harp.
为什么我们知道他在那里弹琴呢
？So why do we know that he was playing the harp?
因为在撒母耳记16:17-18他这么说。
Because in 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 17 until 18 it says,
扫罗对臣仆说：“你们可以为我找一个善于弹琴的带到我这里来吗？”其中有一个少年人说：“我曾见伯利恒人耶西的一个儿子善于弹琴。”是大有勇敢的战士，说话合宜，容貌俊美，耶和华也与他同在。你看哦，因为他的琴的造诣是非常高的。
You can see that he's really skillful in playing the harp.
应该可以说是全国最好的。
that he should be saved the best in the nation.
好到连王宫的臣仆呢都推荐他来为王来弹奏。
So good that even the servants in the palace would recommend him to play for the king.
能够在王的面前弹奏，应该是全国最好的咯。
In order to play for the king, he must be the best in the nation.
所以可以说他是花非常长的时间在弹琴的。
It can be said that he spent a lot of time to play.
大卫不只是弹得好，
he not only played the harp well,
而且也非常有恩膏。
He was also very anointed.
撒母耳记上16章23节他这么说。
In 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 23 says,
从神那里来的恶魔临到扫罗身上的时候，大卫就用拿琴就用手一而弹，扫罗便舒畅爽快，恶魔离了他。你看哦，为什么大卫这么有恩膏呢？
Why is it that David is so anointed?
一弹琴，恶魔就离开了。
So when you play the harp, the distressing spirit will depart from Saul.
一定是他常常赞美神。
It must be he always praised the Lord.
与神有一个非常好的联系。
And had a very deep connection with the Lord.
基于这个原因，他应该是在常常在一个人牧羊的时候。
And it must be that when he was tending the sheep alone,
常常弹着他的琴，
he will always play the harp,
常常在那里赞美神，
he was always praising the Lord then,
常常与神独处，
and always being alone with the Lord.
这个就是他的内室，
and that was his inner chamber,
与神的内室。
The inner chamber with the Lord.
内室不是指特定的一个地方。
The inner chamber was not referring to a fixed place.
内室是指一个只有你和神的地方。
It is referring to a place where you are being with God.
那去到第二点，这个内室里面呢，也能够战胜伤害。
So coming to the second point, we can also overcome hurts in the inner chamber.
刚才我们读的圣经里面。
As we read the scripture just now.
撒母耳来到了他们家。
So Samuel came to his house.
你知道吗？所有的儿子都出现，但是唯独大卫没有出现。
So all the sons of Jesse appeared before Samuel except for David.
他爸爸忘记了他的儿子啊。
His father has forgotten about this son.
大卫在伯利恒人家耶西的家里面，八个儿子里面排行最小。
He was actually the youngest of Jesse that is the Bethlehemite.
但他在家族中却受处于最不受重视的位置。
But he was in the place he, where he was placed the least importance on.
大祭司来要看所有的儿子，但是就是没有大卫。
When the high priest wanted to see all the sons, but David was not there.
就要跟大先知一起吃那个祭物呢，坐席呢，也父亲也没有想到让他回来。
They were about to feast and also eat together with this great prophet, but the father didn't think of asking him to come back.
同时大卫也没有得到小儿子应该有的宠爱啊，或者是保护。
He also didn't receive the love and also protection as the youngest son.
他常常被独自派到外面放羊。
He was being sent outside to tend the sheep by himself.
然后有时来了狮子，还有有时来了熊。
And sometimes the lion and also the bear would come to him.
而他父亲兄长仍然让他在这样危险的地方来牧羊。
The father and also the brother still allow him to tend the sheep in such a condition.
哇，我带我孩子去公园跑，看到有野狗，我们就快点带回家了。
As I bring about my children to the playground, then when there's this wild dogs going around, I just bring them back to the house as soon as possible.
而且圣经说大卫长得双目清秀，容貌俊美。
The Bible says that David was ruddy and also with bright eyes and good looking.
但是没有好像他兄长以利亚这样身材高大，有个英雄的样子。
He wasn't like Eliab that is strong and also tall and also like a hero.
按照常理说，这些种种的人原因都会让人非常的沮丧。
According to logical thinking, we would think that he would be so despair and also in depression.
里面应该有非常多的伤害。
A lot of hurts inside.
很多的扭曲。
A lot of distortion.
很多自怜自哀。
And also self-pity.
常常觉得自己一无是处。
Always feel that he's good for nothing.
大卫在经历了起伏人生后。
And after David experienced all the highs and lows in life,
他在诗篇139篇他这么说。
He described this in Psalm 139 in verse 13 until 16.
请大家注意听，他说：“我的肺腑是你所造的。”
Pay pay attention that he's saying that for you form my inner parts.
我在母腹中，你覆庇我。
You cover me in my mother's womb.
我要称谢你，因为我受造奇妙可畏。
I will praise you for I'm fearfully and wonderfully made.
你的作为奇妙，这是我心生知道的。
Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows so well.
我在暗中受造，在地的深处被联络。
My frame was not hidden from you, and when I was made in secret,
那时我的形体还没有向你隐藏，并不向你隐藏。
And your eyes saw my substance being yet unformed.
我未成形的体质，你的眼早已经看见了。
You've already seen all the substance, even though I was not unformed yet.
你所定的日子，我还没有度过一日，你都写在你的册上。
And in your book, they were all written the days fashioned for me, when as yet there were none of them.
弟兄姐妹，大卫对上帝在人生中的掌权有这么深刻的认知。
David has such a deep understanding of God reigning in his life.
我认为应该是从起初就开始有的。
And I believe that it started from the very beginning.
他被藐视。
He was being despised.
他被遗忘在一个处境里面。
He was being forgotten in a corner.
但是他没有自哀自怜哦。
But he didn't have any self-pity.
而成为一个善于弹琴的敬拜者。
But become a worshipper that was very skillful in playing.
他在危险的旷野中。
In the dangerous wilderness.
他不是自保被动忍受。
He was not just passively enduring and also in self-preservation.
而是积极的去克敌。尽守本分，成为一个大能的勇士。
But he actually actively attacked the enemies, fulfill his duties.
他在不受父母还有兄长的宠爱的处境当中。
When he didn't receive any favor from the father and also his brothers.
他没有性格扭曲啊。
And he didn't have any distortion in his personality.
而是成为一个心灵健康的人。
But become someone who is sound and also healthy.
大卫怎么做得到的呢？
How can David actually perform all this?
就是在内室中。
It was in the inner chamber.
与神独处。
To be with the Lord alone.
那里真的是有个医治的能力。
And there's the power of healing.
不要忘记大卫那时候是没有族长的。
Do not forget that David didn't have any cell leader.
没有牧师帮助他。
No pastor helping him.
连他的父母哥哥们都忘记他。
And even his father and also his brothers forget about him.
但是却在内室里面他得到医治。
But in the inner chamber he received the healing.
很常我们会把错误的寄托放在人的身上。
And often we lay the wrong expectation upon people.
盼望我们的伤害有人可以帮我们得医治。
Hoping that someone can actually help us in our wounds.
那个也没有错。
And that is not wrong also.
但是如果被期待的对象呢，不能帮助我们的时候呢？
But if the party that we have expectation upon could not help us.
我们就进入第二度的伤害。
Then we enter into a second degree hurt.
其实我们却忘记我们有一位医治我们的神。
We have forgotten that we have a God that can heal us.
我们需要做的就是走进我们与神的内室里面。
What we need to do is to walk into the inner chamber with the Lord.
从里面得到医治
and to receive healing from the inside.
真正的医治是来自里面，不是来自外面。
The true healing comes from the inside and not outside.
所以弟兄姐妹，尤其是在这么困难的环境里面
，Therefore, brothers and sisters, in such a challenging situation,
我们真的非常鼓励弟兄姐妹，我们必须要有一个与神独处的一个内室。
We encourage brothers and sisters to truly have the inner chamber where we can interact with the Lord.
因为那个内室就是我们得胜的地方。
And that is the place where we can have the victory.
因为那里有神。
That is where God is.
如果我们有受伤，我们来找神，神会来帮助我们的。
If we are hurt, then God will actually come and help us.
在十多年前，当我知道与神独处内室这个的操练的时候。
More than 10 years ago, when I knew about the practice of being with the Lord in the inner chamber,
我就会很常来到一个房间。
I would often come to a room
来找神。
To come and look for the Lord.
那里只有我和神。
And that it was just God and also me.
初期一进到内室呢。
At the very beginning, when I enter into the inner chamber,
我就会哭。
I will weep.
不知道为什么哭。
Not knowing why.
但是就是好像有很多的委屈，很多说不出的话来。
But it seems that there's a lot of grievances and also a lot of words that we cannot utter.
这可能是成长的背景。
Maybe due to my background growing up.
很多的压抑，很多的不会表达。
A lot of suppression and also didn't know how to express myself.
我记得我小的时候是很喜欢讲话的。
When I was young, I remember I really liked to talk.
然后我记得上一年级的时候
When I was in primary one
上课下课都是我爸爸接送
When I was going to school and also coming back My father would be fetching me
在新的环境新的学校新的朋友新的同学让我非常的兴奋
In this new environment, new school and also new classmate I was so excited
我现在还记得我还看得见当我一年级放学的时候
And now I can still picture myself coming back from school that is in primary one
我就会迫不及待的跳上车
I couldn't wait to go inside the car
然后坐在后座的中间
And to sit at the back in the middle
然后望着那个倒后镜的爸爸
And to look at my dad in the rear mirror
然后我爸爸说科室里面发生的事情
And to converse with my dad according to what happened in the classroom
爸爸你认识那个王小明吗
Dad, do you know about this 王小明
啊怎样怎样怎样怎样
He did this and that
你忘记了没
Did you forget?
我跟你讲过的
I told you before
你知道日复一日我很兴奋跟我爸爸说这些事情
But day after day when I was so excited in conversing with my father
我爸爸好像是第一次听一样
But it seems like my father was hearing it for the very first time
可能他是在驾车
And maybe because he was driving
但是我就感觉到
But I felt this
我不说也可以
It is okay even if I don't talk about this
结果有一天我就开始不说
And therefore one day I no longer converse with my dad about this
我爸爸也没问
My dad also didn't ask me
我就越来越不说
And therefore, I would express less and less.
我真的发现我和我爸爸关系是距离是越来越远。
And I discovered the distance between me and my father grew larger.
那时候我们一家还不是基督徒。
At that time, we were yet to become Christians.
父母需要工作养家，为了供养这个家非常的忙碌。
My parents need to really work to support the family, and they were very busy.
所以很少沟通，很少讲话。
We rarely communicated and also interacted.
渐渐我也不会表达。
And gradually, I didn't know how to express anymore.
造成自己很多的压抑。
There was a lot of suppression.
常常摸不到自己的感觉是什么。
I couldn't understand what my feelings were.
也讲不出自己感觉是什么。
I also couldn't express my feelings.
是个感情非常阻塞的情况。
I entered into a situation where I have emotional blockages.
所以当我一进到内室的时候呢
？The moment when I entered into the inner chamber.
我和神在一起的时候呢
When I was together with the Lord
就是有一个莫名的哭
Then I would just weep unexplainably
这个哭就好像一个水龙头一样
It was just like when the tap water was on
开始把我内心里的感觉给哭出来
I was pouring out all my feelings and weeping it out
这样的状况维持蛮长的时间
And such a condition went on for a prolonged period of time
渐渐我发现我没有那么想哭了
Gradually, I discovered that I didn't like to weep that much anymore.
我感觉到我心里面那个重担是越来越轻省的。
And I feel that the burdens upon my heart has been getting lighter and lighter.
也没有那么容易受伤。
And I will not get hurt so easily.
也没有那么容易被冒犯。
And also being offended.
发现过去让我不开心的事情，如果再，但是再发生，我也 OK。
I discovered that in the past, the things that will upset me, when it happens again, it will not upset me as much.
我胜过了。
I've overcome them.
真的有个很深的感觉，那个得胜不是来自外面的。
I truly have a deep feeling that the victory doesn't come from the outside.
外面人事物还是没变。
And the events, the people were still the same.
但是反而是我的得胜是来自我里面，我跟神面对面的时候。
But the victory comes from the inside when I was able to face with the Lord.
在里面的意志。
That I was healed from the inside.
弟兄姐妹，我们真的是要常常，我们真的要有一个与神。独处的那一世
Brian sisters, we really need to have the inner chamber to interact with the Lord.
那里有得胜的恩膏，还有医治的恩膏。
And there was the anointing of healing and also victories.
那第三呢，在内室中，他也战胜野兽。
Thirdly, he also overcome the beast in the inner chamber.
撒母耳记上十七章三十四到三十五节。
First Samuel chapter 17 verse 34 and 35 says.
大卫对扫罗说：“你仆人为父亲放羊的时候，有时来了狮子，有时来了熊，从群中。”抢了一只羊羔去，我就追赶他，击打他，将羊羔从他口中救出来。他起来要害我，我就揪住他的胡子，将他打死。在面对野兽的时候
，When he's facing the beast，
在没有人看得见的时候
，When no one was actually watching him，
你知道他可以做很多的反应
，He could have a lot of responses，
因为没有人看见
，No one was watching him，
但是就是没有人看见的时候
，But it was precisely because no one was watching，
他去面对那些野兽
，He faced all these beasts，
而且把他赶走
and to chase them away，
还救了这些羊羔
，and even save all the lambs，
这个才是真勇敢
，and that was the true courage。
当大卫可以面对他暗处的仇敌的时候
，when David was able to face the enemies in the dark，
神就会把明处的仇敌交给他
，God will hand the enemies over to him in the public。
最后
，last but not least，
他也把他父亲的羊给拯救了。
He also saved all the sheep of his father.
谢谢 Pastor David.
Thank you, Pastor David.
是的，当大卫他在自己一个人的时候
，Yes, when David was alone,
他常常有单独和神亲近的时刻。
He will often have time to be alone with the Lord.
当他需要独自自己去面对仇敌
，When he needed to face the enemies by himself,
就是狮子和熊的时候
，That is the lion and also the bear.
神给他勇气和力量哦，能够去战胜狮子和熊。
God has given him the strength and also the courage to overcome the lion and also the bear.
因着他常常有这样子的经历
，and because he has such experiences,
让大卫其实对神的信心是非常坚固的。
David's faith in the Lord is actually very firm.
最重要的是
，most importantly，
大卫能够透过在内室中与神亲密的关系
，and through the intimate relationship with the Lord in the inner chamber，
他得到满足。
He was satisfied.
就算是被爸爸遗忘。
Although he was forgotten by his father,
或者是哥哥们的轻视
or even his brothers despise him,
大卫在他的情感上他不容易受伤
David was not easily hurt in his feelings,
他的心灵强健
and his heart and also soul were very strong,
这个很重要
and that is something very important,
因为很多人在还没有开始打仗之前就已经衰弱了
because a lot of people before they even go for the warfare, they were already weakened.
因为在情感上的受伤
，because of the hurts in the emotions，
自己就掉入了自哀自怜的里面。
Therefore, we fall into this self-pity。
我不要参加小组了。
I don't want to join cell groups anymore。
我不要来教会了。
I don't want to come to church anymore。
我不要神了。
I don't want God anymore。
所以，但是大卫呢？虽然年纪小小
，but although David was very young，
但是他里面的灵人是很强大的。
His spirit man was actually very strong。
因着他在内室里面的这个生活吸引了神
，and due to his life in the inner chamber that really attracted the Lord，
所以神差撒母耳来膏他做以色列的王
，and therefore God has sent Samuel to anoint him as the king of Israel。
从那一个时候开始
，from that point onwards，
神的灵就大大的感动大卫
，God's spirit has greatly anointed David。
这个是很大的提升呐
，and that was a great promotion。
就是说以后。
That means that after that,
大卫不只是自己和神有这个连接
Not only does David have this connection with the Lord,
他又带领以色列人一同来连接与神
He also led the Israelites to come and connect with the Lord together.
他不只是自己要去面对自己的仇敌
Not only did he face his enemies by himself,
就是狮子和熊
That is the lion and also the bear.
乃是要带领以色列民哦，去面对他们国家的仇敌腓利士人
But to lead the people of the Israelites to face the enemy of their nation, that is the Philistines.
他不再是牧养他爸爸的几只小羊
He no longer just shepherd a few sheep of his father.
乃是牧养天父爸爸的羊以色列民
，But to shepherd the sheep of the heavenly father, that's the Israelites.
所以，当他被提升，被神提升，在众人的瞩目下
，When he was promoted by the Lord in the sight of everyone，
所以众人瞩目下的大卫是一个怎么样的人呢
？So what kind of person is David in the sight of everyone？
第一。
The first sub-point,
现实中以神中心
God-centered in actuality.
大卫第一场的实体战场
The first physical battle of David,
就是腓利士的巨人哥利亚和以色列军队的骂战
was actually the battle between Goliath the Philistine and also the Israelites.
那时大卫只不过是十多岁的少年人。
At that time, David was only in his teens.
是他爸爸叫他带一些食物呢，去探他的哥哥们，在这个战场上的哥哥们。
It was his father who instructed him to bring some food to his brothers in the battlefield.
同时也想知道一下战情。
At the same time, to know how the warfare has been going on.
哥哥们是否安好
？Whether his brothers were doing well or not.
所以当大卫到了战场的时候
，So when David actually arrived at the battlefield,
刚好听到。 这个哥利亚在骂战。
And he heard that this Philistine Goliath was trying to provoke the Israelites.
挑战以色列军队出来单挑。
To challenge one man in the Israelites' troop to come out and fight him alone.
哪一方输了，就整个的国家呢，就要服侍胜的那一方。
Whichever party that won, that nation will have the victory, and the other nation will have to serve the winning nation.
哥利亚是一个很高大又很强壮的一个巨人。
And Goliath was someone who is big, strong, and also a very great giant.
没有一个以色列军队的人敢出来接受挑战。
There was no one in the Israelites' troop that dared to accept this challenge.
所有的人都非常的惧怕。
Everyone was so afraid.
但是当大卫听到哥利亚对以色列人的这个骂战的时候，
But when David heard that Goliath was trying to challenge the Israelites,
他的反应是什么呢？
What was his reaction then?
在撒母耳记上17:26,
In 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 26, it says,
大卫问站在旁边的人说，有人杀这非利士人，除掉以色列人的耻辱，怎么待他呢？这未受割礼的非利士人是谁呢？竟敢向永生神的军队骂战吗？大卫清楚知道以色列人的身份地位。
David clearly know the identity of the Israelites.
以色列人是与神有约的。
They are the people who have a covenant with the Lord.
万军之耶和华是以色列的神啊。
The Lord of hosts is the God of the Israelites.
仇敌，你攻击以色列就是攻击我们的神。
When the enemies are trying to attack Israel, they are attacking the Lord.
所以大卫呢，凡事都是以神为中心。
So David was God-centered in everything.
他学习用神的角度去看事情。
He learned to see things from the perspective of God.
去想事情。
To think about matters.
再大的巨人，
regardless of how great the giant was,
再大的困难，
and how great the difficulty was,
有神成为我们的盾牌，我们还怕什么呢？
When God is our shield, then we are not afraid of anything.
所以他是一个非常以神为中心的人。
So he was truly a God-centered man.
第二点，
Second point,
在现实中胜过伤害。
He triumphed over wounds in actuality.
28节
verse 28 says,
大卫的兄长以利亚听见大卫与他们所说的话，就向他发怒说，你下来做什么呢？在旷野的那几只羊，你交托了谁呢？我知道你的骄傲和你心里的恶念，你下来特为要看征战。以利亚名字的意思是我神是父。
The name Eliah actually means my God is the father.
我的神是阿爸父。
My God is the Abba father.
是一个很亲密的关系。
It's a very intimate relationship.
可是当遇到巨人的时候呢，
But when he faced the giant,
以利亚却把天父爸爸忘记了。
Eliah has forgotten about the heavenly father.
不敢去面对巨人。
Dare not face the giant.
也不相信他的这个爸爸就在他的旁边。
He didn't believe that the heavenly father was right beside him.
他可能因为大卫他可能听到大卫所说的这些话就给刺激到。
Perhaps he was really irritated by what David had spoken.
恼羞成怒。
And turned his humiliation into wrath.
所以就说了一些诬赖大卫的话。
And say certain things to accuse David.
他说，我知道你的骄傲和你心里的恶念。
And he said, I know your pride and the insolence of your heart.
你下来特为要看征战的。
For you have come down to see the battle.
我们有没有试过被人诬赖过？
Have we been wrongly accused and also misunderstood?
或者是被误解？
Being misunderstood.
我们会不会很受伤啊？
Will we feel very hurt by this?
我们可能选择放弃，离开。
Maybe we'll choose to give up and leave.
还是我们有没有想就是想尽办法解释，证明自己是对的。
Or we try always to defend ourselves to prove that we are right.
还是呢，我们进到内室里面跟神倾诉。
Or do we actually enter into the inner chamber and pour out our hearts to the Lord?
让神对我们说话。
And allow God to speak into our hearts.
让神来医治我们。
allow God to heal us.
因着大卫在内室和神的这个亲密关系
，because David has built this intimate relationship with the Lord in the inner chamber.
建立了他一个对的自信心
，that has built a right self-confidence inside of him.
他知道神怎么样看他
，he knew how God would view him.
他知道神看他为宝贝
，he knew that God viewed him as a treasure.
所以外面的人怎么样讲
，regardless of how people would talk about him.
别人怎样看他并不重要
How other people view him, that was not important.
最重要的是神怎么样看他
Most importantly, how God will view him.
所以大卫对哥哥所说的话他没有照单全收
So David didn't take in everything that the brothers had said.
大卫没有因为这样子而生气离开
He didn't got angry and just leave.
反而积极地想尽办法要击打仇敌
But he was proactive thinking of ways to attack the enemies.
所以他来到了扫罗的面前
So he came before King Saul
但三十四节
In verse 34 it says
大卫对扫罗说你仆人为父亲放羊有时来了狮子有时来了熊从群中衔一只羔羊去然后三十七节大卫又说耶和华救我脱离狮子和熊的爪也必救我脱离这非利士人的手扫罗对大卫说你可以去吧耶和华必与你同在来到第三个点
So coming to my third subpoint
现实中战胜巨人
Overcome the giants in actuality
所以扫罗说你去吧
So King Saul said that you go
当大卫拿着杖还有这个甩石的机弦还有在这个溪水旁捡了五粒石头
So when David actually bring about this rod, this staff, and also the sling, and also the five smooth stones
当他去迎战的时候
And he went and faced this enemy
哥利亚却藐视他
Goliath actually despised him
以色列中没有人了吗
Is there no one in the troop of Israelites?
竟然派个小孩子来跟我打
You actually send a child to fight with me?
可能自己也被藐视，对不对
？Maybe he felt that he was so humiliated.
但是在四十五到四十七节
，But in verse 45 until 47 it says，
大卫对非利士人说：“你来攻击我是靠着刀枪和铜戟，我来攻击你是靠着万军之耶和华的名，就是你所怒骂带领以色列军队的神。今日耶和华必将你交在我的手里。”我必杀你，斩你的头，又将非利士军兵的尸首给空中的飞鸟、地上的野兽吃，使普天下的人都知道以色列中有神，又使至众人知道耶和华使人得胜，不是用刀、用枪，因为征战的胜败全在乎耶和华，他必将你们交在我们手里。大卫对神的信心是有行动的
So David's faith towards the Lord comes with action
他在众人面前和仇敌面前高举耶和华的名
Before everyone and also the enemies he exalted the name of the Lord
宣告万军之耶和华是以色列的神
Declare that the Lord of hosts is the God of Israelites
征战得胜不在乎刀枪
The battle doesn't lie upon the sword and also the spear
乃在乎耶和华
But the battle is the Lord's
然后他就自己去迎敌了
And then he went ahead and also faced the enemy.
很多的时候
Many times,
我们的信心呢是建立在我们看得见有把握的事情上
Our faith will be built on something that we can see and also something that we are certain.
其实这并不是真正的信心
But that is not the true faith.
真正的信心是建立在神的身上
True faith is built upon the Lord.
就好像大卫
Just like David.
他相信神是以色列的，万军之耶和华是以色列的神。
He believed that the Lord of hosts is the God of the Israelites.
他不需要靠这些。
He didn't need to depend on all these things.
所以他就勇敢地向前迎敌。
And therefore, courageously, he just advanced forward to face the enemy.
四十九节到五十一节
，verse 49 until 51.
大卫用手从囊中掏出一块石子来。用机弦甩去打中非利士人的轭狮子进入轭内他就扑倒面伏于地这样大卫用机弦甩势胜了那非利士人打死他大卫手中却没有刀 大卫跑去站在非利士人身边，便将他的刀从鞘中拔出来，杀死他，割了他的头。非利士众人看见他们讨战的战士死了，就都逃跑。然后在52-53节
And then in verse 52 until 53,
以色列人和犹大人便起身呐喊，追赶非利士人，直到加特和以格伦的城门。被杀的非利士人倒在撒拉因的路上，直到加特和以格伦。以色列人追赶非利士人回来，就夺了他们的营盘。所以在现实中，
And therefore in actuality,
大卫拯救了国家。
David has saved the nation.
大卫因着在内室建立了对神的那个信心。
Because David has built the faith in the Lord in the inner chamber.
当以色列国陷入在一个困境的时候，
When the nation of Israel was in danger,
他在战场，在众人的面前见证神。
In the battlefield, he actually testified of the Lord.
他高举神。
He exalted the Lord.
他带领以色列的军队将他们的眼目转向神，
and led the army of the Israelites and turned their eyes towards the Lord,
而不是环境，不是挑战。
And now upon the situation and also the challenges,
他带领以色列人战胜仇敌，
he led the Israelites to overcome their enemies,
然后拯救了整个的国家，
and saved the whole nation.
所以在内室里与神连结。
And therefore, to join together with the Lord in the inner chamber,
与神有一个亲密的关系，是我们能力的源头。
To have intimate relationship, that's the source of our strength.
我记得在几年前的普尔节，
And I remember in the Purim celebration few years ago,
当母堂师母带着团队来公演这个哈大沙歌舞局的时候，
When Delphine Simu from Hong Kong 611 actually bring a team over to perform the Hadassa musical drama,
我是负责总筹的。
I was the head overseer.
两天晚上，的演出爆满。
For the two nights of performance, we had full house.
很多人信耶稣。
A lot of people come to Christ.
哇，很荣耀。
It was so glorious.
然后结束后的第二天呢？
The next day when everything ended,
牧师呢就请我代替他送师母去机场。
Reverend Esther asked me to represent her to send Simu to the airport.
没想到当天非常的堵车。
We didn't expect to have a traffic jam on the way.
我们在路上非常的紧张。
So as we are going to the hotel, we were very anxious.
最后我们真的迟了大概45分钟，我们才到酒店，载师母上机场。
So we were about 45 minutes late before we arrived at the hotel to fetch Simo.
酒店的费用呢，我们也是因着堵车，我们另外一个同工哦，就没有来不及付费。
And due to the traffic jam, another co-worker didn't make it on time to the hotel to pay the fees.
酒店呢就要求师母把过去几天的费用全部要settle
So the hotel actually requires Simu to clear the bills before she check out.
因为我没有事先告诉师母呢，我们在路上遇到的状况。
And because I didn't explain to Simu beforehand the situation we were facing.
所以师母越想越不明白。
So she wasn't understanding the situation then.
因着赶飞机，我们到酒店的时候，我也没有真正道歉，就是为着这个迟到的原因来道歉。
And because we were rushing to the airport to catch the flight on time, I didn't have the chance to apologize to Simon.
在车上呢，也没有交代讲明这个付款的事情。
In the car, I didn't explain the situation about the hotel bills.
所以让师母感觉心里不好受。
That caused Simu to feel uneasy in her heart.
我心里呢就印着很紧张，很惧怕。
And because I was so anxious and also fearful,
在车里呢就保持沉默。
In the car, I just kept silent.
我也不会处理这一个的僵局。
I didn't know how to deal with the situation then.
后来我才知道，这个是我的问题，那个情感严重阻塞的问题。
And afterwards, only I realized that I have this emotional blockage.
结果呢，在师母一路上的就越想就越生气。
So Simu was getting more and more angry on the way to the airport.
虽然最后师母顺利的回到香港。
Although at the end she went back to Hong Kong smoothly.
但是我为了这件事情，心里面还是生气。
But she was still angry because of this incident.
当我们的牧师知道了这件事情之后
，When Reverend Esther heard about this issue，
当牧师告诉我要学习道歉的时候
，When Reverend Esther taught me to learn how to apologize，
我感觉非常的委屈。
I felt that I was really suffering grievances.
我感觉不被理解。
I thought that I was not being understood.
当天我真的是以泪洗脸。
I was really weeping uncontrollably.
越想就越委屈。
The more I thought about this, the more I feel that I was being wrong.
我觉得我这么大个人，我没有这样哭得这么严重的。
And I've never wept like this before in my life.
我心里想，我甚至我不要道歉了。
I thought about this. I even thought that I don't want to apologize anymore.
最多我不要做同工。
At most, I don't want to be a coworker.
那我就不需要面对他们。
Then I don't have to face them anymore.
就是想要逃避。
I just want to run away.
但第二天早上
，But the next morning,
我就进到我的内室。
I enter into my inner chamber.
我将我的感觉、我的委屈、我的怒气，我向神倾诉。
I pour all my feelings, my grievances, and my anger towards the Lord.
我在神面前哭泣。
I was weeping before the Lord.
当我安静下来的时候
，When I quiet down myself,
神带我回想整个的过程。
The Lord led me to think through the whole process.
然后看见自己的软弱和惧怕。
And I saw my weaknesses and also my fear.
越惧怕就越沉默。
The more fearful I was, the more silent I was.
不讲话，不表达。
I didn't say anything. I didn't express.
所以透过那一天早上在内室里面与神独处的时间。
Therefore, through that morning when I have private time with the Lord in the inner chamber,
神让我有力量站起来。
God caused me to have the strength to rise up once again.
不要逃避。
Do not run away.
走出房门。
But to walk out the room.
面对我的惧怕。
To face my fear.
向师母道歉。
And to apologize to Simo.
学习沟通，表达。
Learn to communicate and also express.
感谢神。
Give thanks to the Lord.
师母是接纳我的。
Simo actually accept me.
他包容，他接纳我，而且他给我很多的鼓励。
She embraces and also accepts me and also encourages me.
过了两三年后
，After 2 to 3 years，
母堂，牧师师母呢，再一次呢就把这个611网络会议在 GA 里面进行。
Our mother church hand over the 611 network conference to GA to host.
我们牧师再一次叫我做总筹。
Reverend Esther asked me to be the head overseer once again.
这一次呢是接待列国的牧者。
This time we are hosting the pastors in all many nations.
其实心里面是有感觉的。
In my heart, I still have a feeling inside.
很怕要很怕做错。
I was afraid of making mistake again.
但是这一次的网络呢？
But this time during the network conference,
母堂牧师师母都非常的开心。
Reverend Joshua and also Delphine Simu, they were so pleased.
列国的牧者他们回来的feedback 也是非常开心和喜乐。
The pastors of various nations also gave us very good feedback.
是神在内室里面呢，给我力量站起来，勇敢的去面对。
It was God who gave me strength in the inner chamber so that I can face once again.
才有后来的这个荣耀。
And therefore we have the glory afterwards.
所以弟兄姐妹
，Therefore brothers and sisters,
今天在你面前有巨人吗
？Today are there giants before you?
这个巨人可能是你现在面对的挑战。
It may be the challenges that you're facing right now.
可能是你的经济。
It may be your finances.
你的健康。
Your health.
或者是你的事业
or your career，
你的前面的路你可能会觉得很渺茫。
Maybe you feel that for your future you're not sure。
这个巨人也可能是你过去在情感上的伤害。
This giant may also be the hurts in the past。
你不敢去面对。
You dare not face them。
你在逃避着。
You're avoiding them。
今天透过大卫的这个。生命呢，告诉了我们一个秘诀。
Today, through the life of David, is telling us a secret.
进到你和神的内室里面。
As we enter into the inner chamber of the Lord,
让神来爱你。
Allow God to love you.
让神来医治你。
Allow God to heal you.
来指引你。
To guide your path.
给你力量站起来。
Give you strength to rise up once again.
勇敢地去面对巨人。
Be courageous in facing the giants.
你不是孤单的。
You are not lonely.
因为阿爸父与我们同在。
Because、the Heavenly Father is with us.
好吧，我们一起来祷告。
Let's come and pray together.
天父，我要谢谢你。
Heavenly Father, I give thanks to you.
因为你是我们的神。
Because you are our God.
我们的神是阿爸父。
Our God is the Heavenly Father.
是爱我们的阿爸父。
Is the God who loves us.
今天你透过大卫的生命。
Today through the life of David.
呼唤我们。
You're calling us.
进到内室。
To enter into the inner chamber.
与你相会。
To encounter you, Lord.
特别是在现今的环境
especially in the current situation,
我们特别需要你
we truly need you, Lord.
我们更要在你面前安静自己
we want to quiet ourselves before you,
放下自己
to lay down ourselves,
听你的声音
to listen to your voice.
在那里我们可以得医治
There we can be healed
重新得力
And once again regain our strength
站起来
To rise up
出去面对巨人
Go out and face the giants
你必与我们同在
You shall be with us, Lord
你必带领我们战胜巨人
You lead us to overcome all the giants
祝福我们所有的弟兄姐妹
Bless all the brothers and sisters
听我们的祷告
Listen to our prayers
奉耶稣的名
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Brothers
and sisters,
我们一起来用信心领受神的祝福。
Let us receive the blessing of God in faith.
今这个星期，神对我们真好。
This week, the Lord is truly good to us.
他保守保护了我们每一个人。
He kept and protect all of us.
所以我们知道，在下一个星期呢。
We know that next week.
他仍然用他信实与我们同在。
He still be with us with his faithfulness.
仍然保守保护我们。
He continue to be with us and protect us.
我愿意用诗篇六十七。那篇第一节来祝福我们。
I want to bless you with Psalms 67, verse 1.
愿神怜悯我们，赐福于我们，用眼光照我们。
God be merciful to us and bless us and cause his face to shine upon us.
我们要祝福弟兄姐妹，地已经出了土产，神就是我们的神，要赐福于我们。
And want to bless you, then the earth shall yield her increase, God our own God shall bless us.
神要赐福于我们，地的四极都要敬畏他。
God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him.
神是我们的神。
God is our own God.
我们是他的子民。
And we are his people.
我们要来敬拜他。
We will come to worship him.
我们要用一切来敬畏他。
We fear him with all that we are.
愿神祝福我们所有家中大小。
May the Lord bless us young and old.
我们出去的、工作的、在家中的都是平安。
When we go out to work or we are in the house, we are in peace.
神祝福我们手中所做的一切尽都顺利。
The Lord will bless the works of our hands.
神也祝福我们每一个人呢，家中都有粮。
And the Lord will provide us in our family.
他的祝福是满而又满的。
And his blessing is abundance.
可以祝福其他有需要的人。
And we can use it to bless other people who are in need.
所以我们用信心来领受。
So we receive it in faith.
我们祷告是奉耶稣基督的名字。
And we pray in Jesus' mighty name.
我们一起说。
Let us say,
Amen. 神祝福大家。
God bless you all.